Hi, it's Stacye. How are you? Happy Sunday. I hope everyone is well. Thank you to everyone that took the time to read and or comment on my blogs on Facebook, MySpace, YouTube, and selfcare.com. Thank you so much. I hope that everyone is doing well and you've had a good week and getting ready for Turkey Day. Anyway, so the last blog was It Takes Two to Tango. Let me say thank you to Arthur, Roger, G.I. Joe, Baby Gravity, AJ, Ken, Dana, Gary, Sarah, Charles, Mike, Bruce, Tina, and Mindy. Thank you so, so very much for your comments. So, moving right along, you know, I love for them to tie in. And I got a lot of, and if I forgot anybody that sent me an email, I apologize. Thank you so much for your emails. Got a lot of emails this week about the last, not so much about the last blog, but just about relationships in general. Which I like because it helps me have something to talk about. Kind of helps me, you know, tie it all in. So we're going to tie it all in today. And we're going to talk about trust. Trust is a really interesting thing because a lot of us, we all do, have trust issues because of our past. Here's where we mess up. Let me say that. Our first problem is most of us live in a box and we don't think outside of the box, but worse is that we stereotype. We believe that the opposite sex or the same sex or whomever you're dealing with is going to do the same thing that's been done to you before. We don't let go of the baggage. We keep adding to the luggage. You know, our heart gets a little wounded, and instead of healing the wounds, instead of acknowledging the relationship, finding the blessings and the lessons that came from the experience, we just kind of keep moving and our hearts just getting more and more stabbed and ripped apart without ever healing, without us acknowledging and taking care of that. And so then we move on and we fall into another relationship, and sometimes it's unconscious, you know, and then sometimes it's not. Sometimes it's very conscious. We just assume that they could do one little thing that reminds you of the last person or the last four people, and the next thing you know, all men are the same, all women are the same, you know, and that's not true. We aren't all the same. We could all have similar qualities because, you know, at the end of the day, you're always going to kind of gravitate to what you know. So we all have certain qualities that we look for, but with those certain qualities might come those other qualities that you don't like. But it doesn't mean that you can generalize and say that all men or all women are the same way. So first, the solution is about one, acknowledging yourself, loving and honoring yourself, and trying to heal some of the wounds, and also taking responsibility for your part in each relationship, because we all walk into these relationships with our own baggage. You know, we're so quick to cast blame, but we don't acknowledge that we're just as much a part of what's going on. So first you have to, you know, take responsibility, acknowledge who you are and what you're bringing to the table. You got to ask yourself, what is it in me that's attracting me to that kind of person? What is it in me that maybe is making those qualities come out that I dislike? Because it may be that one, you're attracting to the same type of person, but it could also be that you're not even with the same type of person, but you're bringing out those qualities. So sometimes we have to take responsibility for our trust issues and where they really come from. We've all been hurt, we've all been lied to, we've all been cheated on, so what? Move on. I mean, we've all gone through it. And the only way you can heal is to find the blessing in the lesson. There's always something that comes from every challenge in your life. Everything that happens, you can find a blessing. So even if it seems like an odd blessing, there's something good that came out of it. So when you start looking at things from both sides, the lesson and the blessing, not just the negative or what you consider to be the negative, it's so much easier to leave a relationship when you do and be okay with it and go, you know what, this was a great experience. I learned blah, 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 and I'm cool. and then be able to move into the next relationship, not looking for those qualities that rattle you or that hurt you, or maybe for you to not bring those qualities out in another person. So here is my question. I hope that made sense. Sometimes I talk and I don't know if I said everything that I was thinking. Anyway, here is my question. Do you have trust issues? I would love to hear what you have to say, because we all have them at some level, you know? And I think it's time to maybe address them. Like, why do I have them? Is it because my mother ran out on my father ran out on my mother, and so you think all men are going to run out on you, you know, or that you pick unavailable men, you know, or you pick unavailable women, or you pick the same type of person, you know? I'm going to digress. I was going to wrap it up, but it's something I always think about. You know, we're all so attracted to the visual, and, you know, we all are. And that's the first thing. But, you know, sometimes you have to think about this. I was very blessed at a very young age because I had a very bad car accident, and an airbag imploded on my face. Well, this is like the early airbag stages. Anyway, actually I had two very bad car accidents, but, well, you know, let me back up. I had two. The first one wasn't about the airbag. The first one, I went through the windshield and my face was cut up and hair was pulled out and the whole big deal. And I had a boyfriend who didn't leave me, and, you know, he was cool. It was like, you'll be fine. And that was all good. And the second accident, the airbag imploded. It was a few years later, actually 10 years later, the airbag imploded. And this was the early airbag stages. And I remember I kept saying, oh, my face is burning, my face is burning. And the ambulance guy said, oh, you're just being vain. There's nothing wrong with your face. Well, I woke up the next morning, and most people don't realize, if you are ever hit with an airbag, have them wash your face quickly, because there's a chemical around the airbag that will burn your skin. So the next day I wake up and my whole face is burnt up. And, you know, you never know how you're going to heal when you're burnt. And I'm just thinking, oh my God, I'm going to look like this the rest of my life. And I had to just let it go. I mean, I've had two instances in my life where I really was so conscious that this so did not matter. I always kind of worked on my personality and tried to be a good person, and I never was a pretty girl like, oh, I'm just so pretty, you should do for me. I was never that girl. But those two instances really made me aware that what's inside is so much more important than this. So when I say sometimes, I don't care what somebody looks like, I don't. I really look at their spirit, because this, I know some fine ass men, but they are assholes. So let me just put that out there. Anyway, so my point is that we got to get past this and look into the spirit. If you can look into the spirit, find out who that person is, you won't get caught so much into this, and you won't get so caught up into those same patterns happening. Because a lot of times we're just attracted to what we're familiar with. The look, the air someone has about them. We're attracted to qualities we know. So maybe it's time to step out of the norm, get out of the box a little bit, shake it up, try something new, try something different. Anyway, so tell me, do you have trust issues? Ponder that. I'd love to hear what you have to say. God, I digressed a lot. I'm sorry. Anyway, happy Thanksgiving. I don't know that I'm going to do another blog this week. May not see you until after Thanksgiving, just because it's the holiday, everybody's busy and cooking and blah, blah, blah. But if I don't, have an amazing week. Enjoy your families. It's about the love. It's not about the food. It's about the gathering. So be in that. Enjoy that. Appreciate that. And I will see you very soon, hopefully. So have an amazing week. Love and blessings. Bye.